Are taking it to the next level. They are playing so good.
They are. Yep.
And you know what?
They played a pretty good team the other day, that Weston team. And, you know, they managed to beat them 3-0. Yeah.
And it was domination. I mean, Westford, of all the teams we played so far, Westford was deep in their own zone. I mean, they dropped all 10 players back.
Yeah, they did. Every time.
All right, Bottle's going to chase, give chase, knock her off the ball. Yeah, that's a little interference. That's a little body interference there.
Hey, John, I got to say happy anniversary to Louise.
Oh, yeah, happy anniversary. Yeah, that's right. This is the big...
19 glorious years.
Yeah, that's beautiful. It's beautiful. Did you get her the big diamond?
Yep.
That's good.
Yep, big diamond. No, the 19th anniversary, John, is the paper anniversary.
Oh, yeah, that's what I heard, right.
So I got her a card.
Confetti. You get her some confetti?
Yeah.
Oh, nice play by Leah. Leah passes across, nice crossing, gets it over to Meg. Meg pushes it through. And a little interference by AB.
That was a nice steal there by the Bedford defender.
Yeah, oh, no, I'm sorry. It was interference by the Bedford defender. And we got a corner, our first corner of the day.
So we're going to come off of this.
AB needs to figure out a way to score in these corners.
Right.
It would be very, very helpful when they get to the playoffs.
No doubt.
Okay, they get it over to Leah. Leah passes it across, gets it over to Fallon. Fallon's going to dribble through. Knocked off the stick by Mags. Mags going to do a reverse. Oh, that's going to leave a scar. That went right off the Bedford defender's thigh.
Oh yeah, she's rubbing it up a little bit right now. She got a little pain going on there.
I'm telling you, these girls must have bruises all over their legs and arms and hands. But yeah, so AB is 12-0-1 with a tie against, what was that, Dover-Sherburn?
Dover-Sherburn, yeah.
They were actually down the first time all year against them, 1-0.
They had to come back and score, I think, with 7 minutes left. I think that's what we were told, isn't it?
Yeah.
We weren't able to do that game.
Yeah, that was a Friday game. Well, that's going to, oh, wow. Leah was going to launch that thing, but the defender, ooh, what the heck? Did you see that move?
That was a nice
what
move.
Was that?
That was a nice move.
That was an amazing move.
She put
right
it
there.
Behind herself and through the defender's she legs, turned, I think, at the same time.
She turned away, pushed the ball back away from her, and then turned back to get the ball, and it went through the defender. And Bedford's going to get it up to almost midfield. Oh, it hit one of their players in the leg, so that's going to go back. They almost crossed midfield there, Joe, almost. So Mags is going to play it inside the 50. Ooh, a nice little wrist shot. Carried it in. One of the... knocked down by Leah. And...
That's the bunt move.
That's a dangerous hit. That thing with butt ball was moving about 2 miles an hour.
That's that bunt move.
Heads up. You got to get... Ooh, nice save by the Bedford goalie. Could have used a bigger kick out. Oh, nice wrist shot by Bottle.
That hit the back post of the net.
She's got a pretty good wrist shot, man.
Yeah.
Actually, she has a good wrist shot in hockey, too, from the point. She had a couple of wrist shots last year. I think she scored on one. That's going to go down to Emma Kearney. Emma's going to play it back to Fallon. Fallon's going to chip it over to Mags. Mags going to do another reverse swipe shot. Nope. Oh, wow, did you see that fiddle diddle? She takes it in deep. There's Callie. Oh,
nice try.
And the goalie made a save and a half, a diving save.
Nice try, but Callie dove to knock that thing in.
Callie dove too?
She dove too. Now try to drive it home. Having a little trouble talking today.
That's interesting. I didn't see that. It's a good try. Almost poked it home. And that's going to play side out to Leah. Leah might just launch this thing.
I think that's illegal, John. I don't think you can just drive it.
Oh, you got to. Oh. So that's going to go to Mags. Mags triple teamed. But she gets through it somehow. And the ball goes over to Bedford.
She kicked it, John.
Bedford.
Bedford's got that nice ice cream place out there, Bedford Farms.
Oh, yeah, I know. That's good. Nice and creamy. I could go for an ice cream. Oh, nice play by Cal's on a little reverse chip. Oh, good hustle. Look at, I'm telling you. Tenacious. The back check. That's where AB definitely has an advantage.
That's where they set themselves apart. There's no doubt.
They don't wait for the person to get to the other defender. They back check until, you know, they cause all types of fits for the opponent.
Their speed is unbelievable.
Mags is just dribbling it up. She does a little cut move. Nice steal by the Bedford player. But Mags takes it back, gets it over to Alex. Alex is going to dribble it through. Tries to launch it, just a little miss. There's a launch. Gets it over to a Bedford player, but no, Mags steals it back. Ball's all over the place. Oh, we got
Colleen Francis
is starting on D today, too. Gets it over Callie. Callie tries to get it
through.
Nice
play by Callie to keep that in play, John.
Gets it over to Leah. Leah's got wheels. Oh, what a nice stick handle move right there. She get it over to Bottle. She had Bottle cutting down the middle. Oh, what a tip and a goal across. You know what?
And there's that tipping, right?
Okay, so what did Emma Kearney do that makes her, that sets her apart from everyone else? She stepped right in front of the defender. While the defender, you know, the defender didn't even know where she was. She stepped right in the defender. While she was stepping in front, she tipped it into the net.
Yep.
She didn't wait for the ball to try to get through the defender. She stepped in front of her. Bang, goal.
Yeah. Good aggressive move.
Yeah. She's going to score a lot of goals in her career.
Well, she's a freshman, right?
Yeah, she's only a freshman, so she's got a lot of goals ahead of her.
She's got a bunch already, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Doesn't she have 5 or 6 goals this year?
Yeah, maybe more. Well, she puts herself in a spot to score. She's sitting on the back post, waiting for the cross. This game's all about the cross. Gets it over to Alex. Alex chips it up, gets it. Nice pass, gets it over to Bottle. Bottle takes it down the wing. She can fly. She's going to try to do a cross. Gets it across.
Oh.
Callie needs to get in front of the goalie.
In front of the goalie.
On that shot, if it's not coming to the post, get in front of the goalie and tip it. May was just yelling at her, telling her to do that. Nice steal by Leah. Leah pokes it through. This is a goal. Oh, wow. That was a good play by the defender. That thing would have hurt. What? May's telling Maya right now what Callie should have done. And telling her, look, if this happens, you get in front and try to tip the ball in. Nice pass. Pass it to an open area so Mags can get it. Ooh.
Oh, where is it? Oh, she just missed that one too.
Yeah, she stepped right in front of the defender again. That defender's letting her just walk right in.
She just couldn't get a stick on that, John.
I think she was being held back a little bit by
How do you think Phil Esposito would be as a hill hockey
player? He'd be awesome.
Player.
He'd just sit his fat butt right in front of the goalie, try to tip in the ball.
Every time, right?
Yeah.
That's what he did in hockey.
Look it. Get in front of the... Unbelievable. Unbelievable. What are you doing? What do you think? It's going to go through that defender to get to you? It's not. Step in front of her.
Another corner.
You know what's strange? I know nothing about field hockey, right? Nothing at all, right? But I do know about sports. And Callie will not... Oh, that's a great pass.
And then
Callie got a tip. She got a tip on that. She doesn't even know what to do. No, she doesn't even know what to do.
I think Maggie got that.
No, that was Callie. Callie tipped it in.
Well, Maggie's going to pick it up.
Oh. Okay, Maggie got it then. I thought Callie tipped it in.
Well, I'm not sure. I don't know. She may have tipped it.
All right. Maybe May's telling her what I've been telling her.
But, oh, look at this.
But it's the same, Joe. We play basketball. If you want to pass, what are you going to stand behind the defender? And so what is the guy going to throw an alley-oop pass over the defender's head? Really?
John, I always wanted a pass.
Yeah, you just didn't get any.
I just watched the ball get shot all the time.
Oh, there we go. Leah, nice play right there. Nice play. And then she runs by the defender. Oh, there's a cross. Oh,
another one.
All day long.
All day long.
I'll tell you. Leah is making it easy for Kearney.
Absolutely.
I mean, Kearney's doing her job, though. That ball was a bouncing ball. She got a stick on it, put it right in the net.
That's a nice look. Now, that's a nice pass by Leah.
What'd that feel like, huh? The bees are amazing. They're all over
the place.
There's
got to be a nest up here, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Somewhere.
I don't know. Will they smell something? I don't know. It's weird.
I showered today, too. I
didn't, so that might be it.
Oh, that might be it.
Oh, there's Nicole. Nicole, oh, nice hustle. Almost got it in. Nicole Mansfield's in on left forward.
She's in for Emma Kearney.
Yep, Emma Kearney. Emma's got two.
Hey, John, how was the wine? Did you go up in?
Oh, yeah, the wine was beautiful. We did 5 barrels.
Wow. How many cases is that?
It's 22 cases per barrel, 23 cases per barrel.
Wow.
So, yeah, we did a lot. Ooh, heads up. Ooh, little
chip.
Oh,
who
wants it?
Oh,
man. Oh. Nicole almost got it. That would have been her first goal of the year.
No, she had.
Oh, she has. That's right.
Does she have one?
She scored at the beginning of the year.
She does. She got one.
She almost tipped that bad boy in. But yeah, we did 3 barrels of Chianti, which is basically a mixture.
That's nice with fava beans.
Yeah, fava beans. We did it with we did that with Sangiovese grapes and Merlot. Then we did a whole Merlot barrel. But you know what's strange? We got more juice out of the Sangiovese and Merlot grapes than we did out of the
Just Merlot.
The Merlot, I don't know what was the deal with it, but we got so much juice. Because what happens when you make when you have the barrel, you fill the barrel up with the juice, but it kind of evaporates a little bit and gets sucked into the wood a little bit. So you need to have like extra juice to cap it off.
I see.
That's what the Vinta does. So that's what we poured another 5 carboys worth of juice, which are 5-gallon jugs. And what else do we do? Yeah, we did the Merlot and we did a cab. So we did a cab, a Merlot, and 3 Chiantis.
Chiantis.
Which is basically just a blend. You can blend it any way you want. Like one of the Chiantis we did it with Zinfandel grapes, Merlot grapes, and Alicante grapes, which are really, really fruity. Sweet. All right, so right now, 17:55 left in the first half, 3-0 AB. And nice play by Bottle to fight for that. Gets it through. Tries to do a cross. Get it over to Maya. Caroline Little's going to step up. Little poke check. You know what they say, Joe.
Poke check.
Back check.
Paycheck.
Thank you. I don't know if I made that up or if I just stole it from somebody. I probably just stole it from somebody because I really don't have the brain to make anything up.
I hope you made it up. That's what I'm thinking anyway. No. So they made a sub on defense here too. So Alex is out of the game.
Oh, Alex is out and Maya Cote is in the game. Number 2. Colleen Francis and Maya with Mags. Oh, the nice little cross right there. Good kick out by Smith.
Another Smith.
It's amazing.
Amazing how many Irish people play goalie.
The only Smith that's not a goalie in the league so far is Bentley. Sarah. Nice play by Caroline Little. Oh, nice play by Barrett. Passes it up to Maya, but Maya's got wheels. Oh, that girl's got wheels too. She can run. What's she doing?
She can't control.
I know what she was doing. She was waiting until Maya stole it, then did a fiddle diddle move around it, and then with a cross. Well, that would have been a good cross right there, because she had four or five players sitting. Nice pass. In the back, gets it over to Leah. Leah tries a fiddle diddle, cross right there.
Good luck.
Oh,
there it is.
Oh, bottle.
That's a nice turnaround swipe.
That was a wrist shot, man. She's got a good wrist shot.
I think that was that turnaround swipe shot. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know. She shot it righty. Isn't the swipe lefty?
Oh, that's the reverse swipe.
Oh.
See?
Yeah, I'm screwed up. All right, Caroline Maxwell is going to come in for Colleen Francis, subbing on the go.
We're gonna get
Champagne's gonna go in.
16 minutes left, John.
For Caroline Little.
4-0. I think this is gonna be a. This could be. We may end up talking about maybe some
breaking a record.
Seafood lasagna.
Ooh. Chicken piccata.
Chicken piccata.
Yeah, it's got to be frustrating. It's got to be frustrating if you're Bedford. Beautiful day. Sun's underneath the clouds right now. But one thing about this field, probably one of the better investments AB did with the school system. You know, $750,000, you know, to put this top down. But you can play it 24/7.
Oh, yeah. There's no downtime here either, really.
365.
They play everything, yeah.
Yeah, 365, 24/7. Every now and then you gotta replace a chunk of turf, but you know it's well worth it. Because remember when we had the grass field?
Yeah, it was terrible.
Yeah, you played Pop Warner on it, didn't you?
For 1 year.
But the field's all beat up, and they don't even want you to play Pop Warner on it.
1 year we played Pop Warner on it, and it was a struggle because they felt that we were beating the field up.
Too much.
We never practiced on it, though.
Right.
We were beating the field up for the high school football team.
Now you can play 24/7 on this thing. You can practice on it every day. You can practice on it every hour. Ooh, look
it's
at Bottle go.
Use.
Here's a cross. Ooh, nice save by the goalie.
So our statistician just stepped in.
Yeah, Eric LeBlondo. Did you wish your dad happy anniversary?
Yeah.
Or did you even realize it?
No, they talked about it all last night.
I'm sure your dad didn't say much, but your mom said a lot about it. What'd you get him? Some donuts?
Seafood.
Couple of crab cakes from Twin Seafood?
Pack gum.
There's nothing wrong with a pack of gum. Pack gum's good.
I like gum. Got me juicy fruit. You like juicy fruit?
Yeah.
When's the last time you had a piece of juicy fruit?
A long time ago. I don't remember that. You know why? Because Callie's the only one that chews gum, and she always gets that other crap.
Abba Baba?
I don't know what the hell it is. It costs like $8 million.
Oh, the Trident double loop.
Fruit layers.
Layers.
Oh, nice play by Fallon.
That's a nice move.
And a pass right on the tape. Bottle gets it back up to Mansfield. Mansfield tries to push it ahead to Bottle. Bottle loses the stick, picks it back up, and then steals it. No, she doesn't. Oh, Mags is going to launch this thing. Oh, Mansfield was open, Mags. Maggie Batez is just dribbling it around. It's an art. definitely an odd. Oh, nice little back pass. Gets it over to Maya Cote. No, that wasn't Maya. That was Champney.
Corner. A corner. We're staying on this one.
We're going to stay on this one.
We're
staying
on this one.
You know what's funny? Is Mace says they only have a couple of plays on the corners, but there's about, but they changed the configuration like 42 times.
But it must be the same play, right?
Yeah. No, the girls change it themselves.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is going to hurt. Oh, nice save by Smith.
Nice save. Well, you know, that's what they say. You know, they say that the goalie on a straight shot should never let that thing go through.
Right.
You know?
Unless it five holes, yeah.
I should really be watching more of the camera here since I was just stuck in that corner for about an hour.
Well, you could do the game like Hal Tugel. Hal Tugel puts the camera down on Sarah Bentley and watches a game like this. And then you're like, Hal, the play's down this end. Oh yeah, but it's such a good play. I had to watch it. Yeah, okay. Oh, nice move. Up, out of bounds, Bedford. So we got 11 minutes left in the first half, 4-0 AB, and heading for a blowout. Oh, that's going to hurt. Oh, nice tip. You see, I think what Leah was trying to do on that play
was tip it to the cross.
Grigsby. She was trying to get it to Camille.
To the cross, right?
Yep.
Yeah, I think you're right.
She was trying to tip Maggie's across to the post. Grigsby, and you know what? If she gets it to her, it's a goal.
Yeah.
Because she's sitting on the post. Right there, Griggs! Oh, Camille! Camille got her first goal last game.
Yeah, Monday.
Yeah. What a beautiful day. This is the best time of year.
It's perfect.
You got the foliage. You got the apple cider donuts.
Love apple cider donuts.
Unbelievable. How many can, if you had a large coffee from Dunkin' Donuts, how many apple cider donuts could you eat? I bet you I could eat six and then I'd barf.
I think I could eat eight. Eight or nine. They don't weigh anything.
You know, you eat like, you know, but God forbid you dunk them into the, they don't taste like anything if you dunk them into the coffee. Bedford's got it over half. That goes off of
John, growing Maggie. Up in Somerville, though, we used to like Mike's Donuts. Oh. Each donut weighed 3/4 of a pound.
I know. What's better than that?
Nothing.
Eat the jelly. They had really good jelly donuts. Yeah, I'm a big jelly donut fan. Are you a jelly donut fan? You don't like jelly donuts, do you? No, you like the crullers.
Yeah, I like the glaze sticks.
I used to like...
That's the closest thing you can get to a...
heart attack?
To a 4-pound donut.
Oh, nice and easy, right across. You got Bottle standing. She tried to cross it. She had Bottle standing on the corner there. You see how Bottle came in? So what happened was Grigsby stepped in front of the goalie. Bottle came down to sit back post. It's the way you got to do it.
I don't get to see any of that.
I see it.
I know you do.
I see it because I'm not doing anything. All I'm doing is talking and picking my nose.
No. I don't get to see it because I'm following the ball.
No, I know.
Most of the time. Except for like right now where I don't know where it is.
Bedford gets there. She's going to dribble it up.
Oh, this she girl's, kicked that.
She's got a few. She got a little bit of a stick skill there. Oh, nice knockdown by Maya. Oh, yeah. So a little bit of body interference. I'm telling you, if you're looking at Maya... And Caroline, I think Meyer and Caroline Little look very, very similar when they play.
Yeah.
One's 20, one's 2. Oh, nice play by Bottle. Oh, and she just accelerates. That's off a leg, but we got the ball, so no call. Meg, wrist shot. Bottle trying to fight for it. Can she get a wrist shot off? Goal, save.
Oh, nice save. Another nice save.
Nice play by Smith to step out on that shot. You know what I mean? Champney keeps it in. What the heck was that call?
Nice job by the Bedford goaltender there.
Yeah, she stepped out right into Leah, and Leah's like, she shot a laser, but she kicked it out. Nice stop by Meg. Meg gets it over to Leah. Leah tries to dribble it through, does dribble it through, and gets
and a
goal. That was just persistence right there. You know something, Eric? Why don't you go home and make some dinner for your dad? It's their anniversary. What are you talking about? See, I told him. I told him right there. Make some mac and cheese.
Eric made mac and cheese for himself last night. I knew because there was like 3 or 4 pounds of macaroni on the floor.
Well, he knows the maid's coming in the morning to pick up everything.
Yeah.
Be like Tommy Mack, man. Make soup. I was over his house when I was in college. I was over his he made soup, right? He started picking stuff out and throwing it on the floor. And instead of telling his mother, is that what he's did? He told his mother, I threw up.
Nice.
Hey, thanks, Tom.
All right, so where are we at? We got 6.5 minutes left in the first half. 5-0 AB.
Yeah, this is going to be a high-scoring game.
Once again, I don't think Sarah Bentley's going to get a shot.
No. Caroline takes a look, surveys the field, stays with it, dribbles it up. Nice job, Caroline. Gets it over to Maggie, dribbles it through, pushes it through again, tries to push it through again. Fights, gets it back, looking, close quarters, and we got a corner. Strangely enough, I messed up my shoulder the other day, and I think a bone chip went from my shoulder into my elbow. Is that possible?
Yeah, yeah, just, you know, it flies down the propeller tendon. The propeller gland. Well,
Joe, get a picture of this cameraman.
Sorry, I'm coming. I will.
Is that the Italian ice guy? Ooh, nice tip. Is that the lemon and Raz guy?
I don't know. I gotta get him though.
His camera is half the size of him.
Where is he?
Right down there. He's like heading towards the Bedford bench. Gotta be a Bedford guy.
There he is. Lemon Raz.
What do you think of that guy?
There he is.
You can't buy a hat like that anymore. Oh, heads up. Nice job by Caroline.
That guy had the best slush in the world.
Oh, the Lemon and Raz guy?
Oh, the best. Trumfield, Somerville. The raspberry slush still had the seeds in it.
Oh, yeah. I know. It did. It was amazing. He didn't make it himself. Did he get it from
Richie's? No.
Richie's?
No. I think he made that himself, John.
Well, I'll tell you right now. Now it's a blue ras. They don't have a red raspberry anymore. You get blue ras. And there's no seeds. I feel like hot dogs tonight, man. How about a good hot dog? Would a good soft hot dog bun with some butter on it? Oh, nice tip.
Oh.
You know, for a freshman, she has, like, her field hockey IQ is very, very high. You know how they talk about basketball IQ, how LeBron James has a high basketball IQ.
Yeah.
For those of you who haven't heard Joe just muffle, it's because he didn't have his microphone on. So if he's been muffling the whole time, yeah, that's probably it. Nice job by Bottle. She's taking it to the house. Ooh, nice little wrist. Oh, Camille almost got her second goal of the year, but a good kick save by Smith.
I think they heard me fine right through your microphone.
Well, you have a microphone. We're sitting there, too. So. Yeah. That's a beautiful thing. Yeah, I can't wait to taste this Chianti, man. It's going to be unbelievable. Oh, nice play by the Bedford D to get it out of harm's way. and we got a sprint going on, but here comes Maya. Nice job by Maya. Good hustle, good anticipation, good stick. Meg tries to get it over to, that's Jill. Jill Fenneman's in the game at right forward, or right wing. Will they call it right wing?
Right wing. Kenny Hodge. Wasn't Kenny Hodge a right wing?
He might have been. It was him. It was either him or Wayne Cashman.
Cashman.
Wayne Cashman, Kenny Hodge, Phillip Esposito. One of the highest scoring lines ever. I mean, Phillip Esposito had 70 goals one year. 77 goals or something like that. Nice job by Caroline Little to push it through. Gets it over to Bottle. She's got some space. You don't see too much space like that. Good cross. Gets, ooh, you see Grigsby just threw the defender out of the way. That was a good play. Little chip over, gets it to Caroline Little. Caroline Little, Grigsby, get, look at, she's aggressive. She's good. She's good. She goes for the ball, man.
That goalie's made a few nice saves in a row here, maybe
like
three or four.
On a couple of redirects, too.
Yeah, three or four nice saves.
Heads up.
Good job staying with her there, whoever that was.
Oh, that was Caroline Maxwell.
Good job.
Jill fights for it, gets it through, almost. Sweep, little sweep maneuver. Meg, up to Jill. Jill knocks it down. Back to Meg. In hockey, they talk about move your feet. You know, always move your feet. Never just make plays standing still. It's the same in field hockey. That just went off of Bottle's foot. Oh, they're letting it go.
Oh, nice,
nice save,
save
by Smith. Another save by
Another
Smith.
Another one.
Another save by Smith. Smith's alone. Oh, Smith makes a dive. And I don't know
if she got a piece of that or not, but it ended up going wide.
Did it hit the post?
It may have. I don't know.
It either hit the post or hit the defender in the arm.
Yeah. 15 seconds left.
So, first half, pretty much dominated by AB, 5-0. And Bedford, if they have a hope, it's that Smith keeps playing solid and they maybe get a shot on Sarah. So we'll be back for the second half after your messages from Trin Seafood.
Hey, welcome to Trin Seafood. This is your captain speaking. Come down and get some nice fresh cod, swordfish, scallops, tuna, whatever you like. Put it on the grill. It's a beautiful night.
All right, here's the start of the second half. Something interesting is that AB's playing a 3-2-3-2, and Bedford's playing a 3-3-1.
3-3-3-1?
A 3-3-3-1. There's Emma. Emma gets it over to Leah. Leah passes it back to Mags. Mags, oh, no, that wasn't Mags. That was Bottle. Bottle, nice steal. Gets it over to Mags now. Mags is going to accelerate through. And that's a little bit of an interference. And it's going back the other way. So some dominance right now. 5-0, AB over Bedford. Historically, Bedford hasn't been able to compete with AB the past few years anyways, 5 or 6 years. Oh, that's off a foot. Bedford's gonna control it. Gets it up. Tries to push it through. Oh, Caroline Little down, now up. She just did not care. She did not care that she hit the ground. Oh no, her arm might be a little messed up there.
Looks like she's limping or something. She's got something going on, a little bit of pain somewhere.
Yeah, she's rubbing the arm. There goes Mags. Nice long pass to Emma Kearney. Emma's gonna chip it through.
Oh.
And she does. See how she got her leg out of the way? That was a good play. I'd like to take it down. Get to the front of the net. No, go to the front of the net. She doesn't get it.
I'd like to see.
You need to stay in front of that defender. If you're not in front of the defender, the ball will not get to you. Unless by some miracle chance.
She can't hear you up here, John.
I'm sorry.
Just so you know.
Well, that, I think that hit Mags in the foot.
On that play, I would like to see her step up and come to the ball, though, John.
Yeah.
And not just sit and wait for it.
No, go to the ball. Go to the ball. Be in front. Give Emma a path to make a pass.
No. I'm talking about Emma.
Oh, Emma.
You know how she kind of just stayed back and waited and waited and waited?
Yeah.
I would have liked to seen her come to the ball and then maybe come around the defender and bring it to the center of the field.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Leah's going to take that. Ooh, almost. This defender's pretty good, giving Leah a hard time, and that's not easy to do. But Meg's going to take it. Ooh, nice pass. You got to get to the front of the net. Oh,
there's a goal.
Down. There you go. Yeah, but you know what? It went through a defender to get to her. There goes my whole philosophy. Because when I tell her my philosophy, she's going to say, that doesn't work because I scored a goal without using what you said. Not that I know anything about field hockey.
And don't say anything.
Yeah, I know, but I like to. All right, Bedford's going to play it in. 26 minutes left in the second half with AB6, Bedford, Zettel. Mag's going to do a little fiddle-diddle move, but lose it, but then pass it through. Callie knocks it down, takes a look, gets it up to...
Oh, good look to the middle.
Gets it up to Maya. Maya is subbing in for Leah. No, get to the front of the net. What are you doing?
She can't hear you, John.
You know what? I'm going to tell you something. She's getting it. It's just like a second and a half too late. You can't tell because you're on the camera.
I know. I can't see anything but the ball.
Well, they got a new orange ball in there. That's interesting. Little glow ball action. Oh, miss hit. That brings the ball the other way. AB's going to take it up. Meg plays it off a foot. Meg steals it. That was an interesting play. Nice little back pass. Meg tries it. Ooh, and then she drops it. And she gets the ball. Wow, that's crazy.
Corner. I'm on it.
Strangely enough, even though we're winning 6-0, this is only like the third or fourth corner we've had all game. Mags is going to play it in. Gets it over to... Little chip up, but Bottle can keep it in, and she does. Fights it to get it back to Meg. Meg can't get it, but nice play by Fallon. And the ball's going the other way with Bedford. Bedford's going to take it at their own 25, swing and a miss. Good chip up, but Fallon read it all the way. You know what? Before I started announcing, nice play
nice
by
play
Alex.
By
a little
Alex.
Chip up, gets it over to Bottle. Good play by Alex. Bottle tries to get it in. It goes off. Maya has control of it. Maya's taking it right to the net, y'all. And a save, a diving save by Smith.
Smith's doing a nice job.
She's playing very, very well. I mean,
so what did you start to say before you started to announce?
Oh. The skill level in this game. I mean, I thought it was just, you know, take the ball and rip it. But the stick handling skills on some of these girls and the eye-hand coordination on some of these girls
kind
is
of amazing.
Crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, it really is. It's almost like baseball. The eye-hand coordination. Nice play by Maya to knock that down. She tries to do a cross. Just missed it.
Oh, good play. Who was that?
Caroline. Pokes it through. There's a little bit of space for her. So Caroline's going to play it again. Meg's going to take it at the top. Bedford has everybody inside the 20 right now. Wrist shot. Oh, and a goal!
Did that go right by her?
Yeah. I don't know what happened. I mean, she couldn't have seen it.
She must have lost that. So where's the sun?
Nah, it's up a little high. I think one of her defenders blocked her view.
Maybe tipped it?
Hmm.
7-0, AB. So, John, we'll see a running clock the rest of the way here. Whether it's whether there's a timeout, a helicopter lands on the field, whatever it may be, we're going to have a running clock here.
Hmm. Julia Nyland just came in, and she has the ball. A little reverse sweep, tries to get it up to Emma. Oh, nice steal again, and pushes it through, gets it over to Maya. Maya going to take it down the baseline. Maybe not the baseline, the wing. Pass it over. Speaking of wing, Bruins play tonight.
Chicken wings?
Ooh, Callie tries to do a reverse sweep.
Oh!
Staying on the ball.
Oh, stay there.
Ooh, heads up. So, in the game now, we have Colleen Francis on D. Julie Champagny playing back midi. Maya Cote playing back midi. Some wholesale changes going on here. Grigsby looks like she's a forward midi, not a defensive midi. Nice play by Maya.
No, John, I'm kind of surprised they haven't changed the goalie yet.
That's true. That's probably going to happen, though. Can you change a goalie on the fly?
I think you can. I'm not sure.
There's a change right there. Caroline Maxwell comes in. Maya gets it over to Grigsby. Grigsby, a little fiddle-diddle, gets it to Champagny. Champagny pushes it up, gets it over, just over Nayland's stick. Just to let you know, fans, ranch sunflower seeds are unbelievable. Just gonna let you know that. It could be that I'm starving to death, but they were really, really good. Oh, wow, she's got some wheels. Nice pass up. So Bedford gets it over half, no go. And here comes Champagny. Nice, whips it up, gets it over to Maya. Maya's going to try to push it through, but that went off a leg. That should be our ball. Oh, the whistles have been put away, Joe.
I think so.
The whistles have been put away.
It's okay with me.
So what do you think of the new clock that they're going to put in baseball? Oh, look at that by Maya. And a diving
save. Oh,
nice save. You know what? You just don't see that often in field hockey. A diving save by the goalie. Coming right out face first at the ball. Beautiful save.
Good job. Good job.
That was
by
a great
goal.
Save. Grigsby passes it over, gets it to Maya. Maya chips it through, nobody home.
What clock?
They're going to put a clock on the pitcher? They're going to put a pitch clock.
I like it.
I think it's a great idea. And they're thinking that it's going to be somewhere around 12 seconds
between pitches.
Between pitches, the batter cannot leave the box. Batter has to have 1 foot in the box at all times.
Oh, yeah. They tried to do that before.
Yeah.
They tried to do that last year.
And they're gonna. Right now, they...
Nice play, Alex.
Nice job. Good stick handle. Takes it. Passes it over. Gets it over to Grigsby. Grigsby's going to take it up the wing. Get it over to Fenneman. Fenneman, nice little chip. Pass it back to Grigsby. Ooh, nice job. Nice little one-time pass.
That was a nice look right there.
That was Champney right there, Julie. That was the same play that Leah did to get Emma Kearney her first goal. That one time. We got changing on the fly now.
Yeah, we got another sub.
I'd like to see Fenneman score a goal. Everybody's mother. Jill Fenneman. That's what Callie calls her.
She makes the peanut butter brownies, right?
Oh, yeah. She can cook. She's a baker.
She's a baker?
Yeah, yeah.
What's going on here?
Little free hit. Wrist shot, knocked down by Maya. Mansfield's going to get it, try to keep it in, but it's out of bounds. Well, 7-0, 17 seconds left in the second half. And we got a man down. Man down in the booth. Statistician went down. Just fell into the barrel. That was an accident.
He's trying to chase away a bee over there, John. I think he stuck himself in the eye with a pen. Those stat guys, though, they're a little goofy anyways.
Oh, yeah. Number clowns. Oh, nice play by Maya. Gets it over to Mansfield. Mansfield's going to try to get it back to Maya. Fallon's going to come up, steal it, pass it down to Mansfield, and it's out of bounds. Yeah, I got something in my elbow. I think it just dropped down from my shoulder. It's not a good one.
You don't need all the bones, John. You don't need all the bones in your shoulder.
I'd like to take this one out of my elbow. Oh, nice play by Fallon. Tries to wrist it across. Jill tries to get there, but no go. Oh, heads up. Heads up. Nice job by Champney. Champney's going to take it up. Pass it ahead. Get it over to Mansfield, but no go. No go. All right, ball's going to be brought in. And Bedford's going to play it up on a free hit. Looks like the sun went under a huge cloud. Ooh, nice dribble. You know, you look at the Bedford team. That girl was dribbling it up, right? But the one she was trying to pass to was running parallel with her. You know, wouldn't you think you'd want to be like, you know, 10, 15, 20, 30 feet in front? Nice play by Maya. Maya chips it up, gets it over to Jill. Jill tries to push it through to Maya Haggis, but no go. And Grigsby takes control. Nice pass. Gets it over to... Oh, that's Nyland right there. Gets it to Mansfield.
See, that was a nice job right there by Maya. Going to the ball. Beating the defender to the ball.
Yeah, well, she's fast. Heads up. Rip. Knocked down by Colleen and taken away. Nice play by the Bedford Ute. Look at, see how all three girls are running together, like almost parallel? Nobody gets ahead. It's very difficult. One person can cover that. Nice pass. Gets it over to Grigsby. Grigsby's moving. Gets it up to Fenneman. Fenneman knocks it down. Going to take it down the wing. Keep skating with it. Skate with it, Jill. Nice job. A little reverse sweep pass. Grigsby get it over to Champney. Little under the stick. Knocked down by Colleen, but hit her in the foot. And those three girls are perfectly parallel with each other again. I don't know. If I'm the coach, I'm like, spread the hell out. Really? How are you going to get the ball downfield when all you guys are running at the same pace? Oh, Caroline almost went down. She almost blew a tire.
I didn't think they were going to blow the whistle there. The ball was out of bounds by about a foot and a half. I thought they were just going to let it go.
Just going to keep letting it go?
Yeah.
Well, the second half is moving. Ooh, we might get a shot on net. Champney tries to get it out. Ooh. Oh, that nice job by Champney to knock that thing down.
Where did that hit her?
I think it hit her in the stick. I don't think it got her in the hand. Oh, we got our first corner. And we got a clap from the first thing the Bedford fans had something to clap about. Yeah, it's funny. We got that three-legged nice play right there by Champney.
Three-legged horse.
We got that three-legged dog down there. It reminds me of that story, you know, when I was a kid, saw the sign. It said, dog lost, blind in one eye, can't hear, missing one paw, goes by the name Lucky. Yeah, okay.
And he's lost, right?
And he's lost on top of it all. He's probably screwed. Probably somebody's turning him into like
dog chowder.
Beef stew. Dog stew. Yeah, see, look at all the girls. That front line, they're parallel. Nobody goes deep. And you know what's weird? The coach hasn't said anything about it. They're parallel with each other the whole game.
Maybe that's how she wants them to play.
What are you talking? You can cover it with one person.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying there, John.
She wants them like that? She wants one person to cover all three people?
Maybe.
I'm not digging it. Get down the field. What are you doing? They run down the field as a threesome. Get up the field, spread out. In basketball, they talk about the triangle. The Lakers used to play a triangle. And in hockey, you want kind of like a triangle too. You want the person with the ball, then another one going to the net, and then another one following in maybe like 10 or 15 feet behind. You got somebody to pass, so you either throw it to the net or you throw it to the second guy through. I like it when it's very easy to defend when the three girls are like running up the field on the same lateral line. Caroline Little subs in for Caroline Maxwell. They both do a little sprint, get a little work out there. And Colleen France is going to dribble it up. Nice stick skills. Good pass, gets it over to Fenneman. But took a weird hop over a stick, and it's going to be played in by Bedford. But Fenneman's going to steal it back and take it to the hole, y'all. Gets it over to LeBlondo. LeBlondo tries to pass it through. That could be a corner, but Colleen France's shot, save. Save again by Smith. I bet you Smith's got about 30 saves. 25
saves. She's made a few. She just played well.
She just made two in a row right there.
She's played well. There's no question about it.
And is that going to be a corner?
I got to tell you, Johnny, if there was no goalie in net, this game would be out of control.
I got to remember those guys' names from dodgeball. What did they call them? Was it
Cotton.
Scooter?
Huh? Cotton.
Cotton. Cotton. Oh! Oh! LeBlondo, is that LeBlondo? No, that's not LeBlondo. And ball's out of bounds.
Too bad, that was close.
Oh, that was Mansfield that was trying to push it through.
Number 19.
That was Mansfield, Nicole. She was trying to push it through, but hey, you know what? You keep playing the ball until they tell you not to play the ball anymore. That's going to be played in by Grigsby. Ooh, Mingye, that's going to leave a scar. Champney went for the ball and like crushed the Bedford's girl's ankle. She's walking with a little bit of a limp there. She wants to come out. And that's going to be a sub right there. That definitely hit a foot. Bedford's going to play it up. Eight and a half minutes left. AB up 7-0. That's going to get knocked down by Grigsby. Heads up. Beautiful play. Nice job. Was that Champney? passes over to LeBlondo. LeBlondo's going to fiddle diddle, tries to sweep it through, get across. Ooh, nobody home.
I think we got a corner here, Johnny.
Wow. And this is a corner without our regular crew in there. I don't know if there's one player. Oh, here's Leah. Leah's moving up. So there's one player within this crew that's a regular on the corner. That's going to go into Leah. Heads up. Nice save. Toe save. She's a good player. I wonder if that hurts.
I don't think so.
Does that hurt when it hits you in the toe like that?
Yeah, they're all padded, man.
Yeah, but what kind of pad?
That's that heavy-duty Kevlar.
Is that Kevlar? They put Kevlar on the foot of those things?
Yeah.
That's funny. Callie's got Kevlar in her goalie helmet.
Yeah.
Go to the net.
Same type of thing.
Somebody's got to go to the net. There you go. Nice job. Greasy gets it back. Oh, that's a dangerous hit.
I think it's the same type of thing, Joe.
A little Kevlar on your foot. What the? Oh, that's my boy. Nice pass up. Gets it through, and we're almost going the other way, but Grigsby steals it. Good push through. Nice knockdown. Gets it over to Callie. Callie tries to push it through. Shot on net. Nobody home. Oh, wow. All right, Callie's going to take the ball from the corner. Oh, we got a corner.
6 minutes left, 7-0.
Interesting that we scored 5 goals in the first half, and we really haven't got much going here. That's going to get passed out. Colleen's going to get it over to Champagne. Champagne's going to take the wrista. Go over to LeBlondo. LeBlondo, let that thing launch. Crossing. Nobody home. There's a battle inside.
Oh, nice play.
That was a good play by Jill. Jill gets it across. Oh, nobody home. The goalie's on the ground. She can't tie it up. She ties it up. That's going to be a free stroke. Another shot. Oh, that goes back. Gets it up. Another shot. Champagne took a wrist shot. And it's going to be another corner.
You sure she can't tie that thing up?
You can't tie it up. You got to keep that ball moving. If she ties it up, it's a corner. I mean, it's a free stroke, penalty stroke. All right, Nyland's going to take it side out in the corner. She's going to play it in, gets it to Leah. Leah's going to launch one. Good kick save. Another kick save. Another kick save. LeBlondo's going to take it. Oh, she could have launched that thing.
That goalie just made 5 saves in a row.
That goalie's a good player, man.
5 saves in a row.
That goalie is a good player. And there's a rip knocked down by Callie. Callie's going to take it up the wing. Nobody home. Yeah, just keep it. Take it deep. Get it deeper. She tries to get it over to Jill. Jill steals it. Nice play by Jill. Cross gets it over to, oh, nice shot. Knocked down. Another save. That's 2 saves by Smith right there. She's single-handedly keeping the score 7-0. You got to give some kudos to her. Oh, Caroline Little hits it out. No whistle blown at all. Oh, nice play by Grigsby. By the way, found out some information from her parents. Big fan of Twin Seafood Chowder. Big fan. LeBlondo tries to throw, oh, tries to lead Fenneman, but that hit Fenneman in the foot. Oh, but no call. Fenneman tries to get it across to LeBlondo again. And Grigsby's going to play it up. She gets it over to Champagne. Champagne launches a one-timer, which I'm a big fan of. And the ball's out. Push through. And the girls are going to run down the field. All 4 of them, side by side.
It's a very methodical way to think about field hockey. You look a little bit confused in what I said there, John.
I can't believe the coach hasn't said anything yet. Is that how they do it all the time?
I don't know.
It doesn't make any sense to me, man. They got no layers. You know, like, look at AB. They got layers. You know, you got a couple players behind, couple players in front. They have no layers. Bedford. Ooh, nice chip. Good save. Good kick out by Smith. Fought her 35th save, if not more.
Still not a shot on Acton Boxborough's goalie.
Uh-oh. Alex Oblunda's going to go in as a forward. See if she can pop one home. That ponytail's all over the place. And that's going to get chipped out, but Champney's going to pop it right back in. Gets it over to Nyland. Colleen Francis takes a look. Oh, she's going to let it go. We need a tip. No go. May was telling us, shoot it more to the far post than to the near post, you know? Which is, even in hockey, that's what you want to do.
Well, that makes sense, right? I mean,
like in hockey, if you're coming down the right wing and you take a shot, you want to shoot far post. Very rarely are you going to beat the goalie on a shot straight in. So what you want to do is shoot far post, and hopefully the wing is coming in. The goalie kicks it out, and the wing is right there to pop it in.
Oh, we got a little runaway.
Yeah, but Mags is there. She's going Maya Cote.
Oh.
A swing and a miss. She's going to get that up to Grigsby. Grigsby's going to chip it through. Tries to chip it up to Alex Oblunda, but no go. That goes up to Alex. Alex has a lot of space. She's going to launch one. Cross bouncing. Beautiful cross. Francis. Oh, the sweep. Oh, she wanted one. She's a good player.
No. Colleen.
Colleen, yeah, she's a good player. That was a nice play right there. She poked it through, and immediately she went into that reverse sweep.
55 seconds left, John. They keep blowing the whistle. This thing's just going to run out.
All right, 50 seconds left, 7-0, AB, against the Buccaneers of Bedford. The Bedford Buccaneers. And here they come, running parallel down the field. Actually, they had a little bit of layering right there. But Maggie will have nothing of it. Ooh, heads up. Grigsby's going to get it, take it over on the sideline, plays it in. Alex is going to take it. She almost passed one through to Callie, but, you know, cousins sometimes don't. Oh, she's down. She's down. You know what's tough in field hockey? There's no graceful way to fall in field hockey.
No, you go down,
you always go down like a rock. Oh, that's too bad. Mansfield just took
and
it off.
And usually on your face.
Yep, and usually on your face. All right, so that's going to be the end of it on a beautiful October mid-evening. 7-0 Colonials against the Buccaneers of Bedford. And you know what, Joe? One thing which was really cool about this game is that goalie from Bedford was really, really good.
Yeah, she played really well.
And you know what's strange is Sarah Bentley is probably just as good as her, but, you know, we don't see the shots.
I think, you know what, I think you see a lot of good goalies. There's a lot of good goalies in this league, and you know, playing Acton Boxborough,
they get
challenged.
They get shots, yeah.
They get challenged, and, you know, the goalies for AB, they get very little. You know, you almost want to see them get more as the playoffs come around, you know, because you want them to be ready for game time action, you know.
But the one thing that is good, like with Sarah, is that she's getting these shots from these players every day.
In practice.
So, you know, that's a good thing.
Yeah. So, anyways, they play again on Friday.
Yep.
I don't think we'll be here on Friday. So.
All right.
So we'll see you sometime next week.
All right. See ya.